Welcome to the 2023 DADS Virtual Conference. I'm David Hirsch, and it's my pleasure to welcome everybody. And as we're waiting for others to filter in, I thought it would be fun to go into the chat and put what city and state you're from in the United States, and if you're from a different country, what city and country you're from, if you would. So I'll get it started. And it'll be fun just to see where people are from. And this is the, while you're doing that, this is the fourth time that we've been able to do a virtual conference. For those that were involved way back when, the 2020 conference was an 80-person in-person conference at Willow Creek Church here in the northwest suburbs of the Chicago area. And because of COVID, we pivoted and we went virtual. And we were pleasantly surprised to get well over 100 people to register from 30 different states here in the US and 8 different countries. And it's been a virtual experience ever since. And I dare say, no matter what happens post-pandemic, we'd like to conduct a virtual conference like this on an annual basis or periodically. And it's a great way to bring people together from faraway places in a very cost-efficient way. And what's sort of interesting is that we went from being more of a face-to-face type of operation, making matches with the Special Fathers Network one-on-one, to doing a number of different things. So what I'd like to do is review what we hope to accomplish today and then make some brief introductions. So I'm gonna go share my screen. This is the conference. I'm hoping that you can see what I see. So I'll provide a brief overview, introduce my good friend, Wayne Messmer. Then I'm gonna ask Duncan Kia and Nathan Werner to talk about their experience with the meetup groups and mastermind groups. And then we're gonna have our first featured speaker, which is Frank McKinney, who's going to talk about overcoming adversity. And then we'll go from there to Jim Stobel, who's going to make a presentation entitled You Don't Have to Be Blind to See, which is actually the title of his first of his 51 books. Then we're going to go into our various sessions. You'll have a chance to choose between three different topics: early intervention, athletics and other activities, employment and finding purpose in the first round. Then we're going to go into a networking session, which Shonan, who's our conference coordinator, will break us up into groups of about 4, 3 to 5, to be specific. And you'll have about 30 minutes just to get acquainted and network. That's what we've been told by past conference attendees, that they really enjoyed the time just getting to know other dads. And then we'll go back into session 2. You'll have a chance to choose between siblings and family balance, self-care, and residential and housing alternatives. And then when we're done with that, we'll go back into our second networking session, and then we'll come back, everybody will come back into the first Zoom channel. We'll hear from Joe Montaigne, who's been with us from the very beginning. And then one of our featured speakers is also the iconic Temple Grandin, who's gonna make a presentation on putting disability into perspective. So that's just a brief overview of the schedule for the day. And I thought it would be interesting to make reference to the resource, the rich resource that we have with the website that we've created. And what I'd like to do is just take 1 or 2 minutes to bring people's attention to what's there and where some additional resources are. And some of our longtime participants have said, I didn't know that you had all this information at the website. So this is the homepage. You can sign up to be a mentor or ask as a mentee. This is information about the virtual conference. You know that we do a podcast. All the podcasts are listed on the homepage, where you can go get the additional podcasts. So Jesse White's podcast just came out yesterday. Some of you know that we have a Dad's Honor Ride coming up. I'm one of the 4 riders. We have 12 crew members, and that'll be a 3,100-mile bicycle ride across the U.S. There's our audiobooks. There are 3 that have been produced. There are two that are finished. One will be released before Father's Day, and the other will be released after Father's Day. The one coming out before Father's Day is on cerebral palsy, and the one that's coming out after Father's Day is going to be on losing a child. So under this tab, I'm not going to go through all of it, but just to make reference to what's here, why do we start the 21st Century Dads Foundation? What's our mission and vision? There's a timeline, sort of historical perspective. Here's bios on each of the board members. We have a laundry list of dozens and dozens of partners and affiliates. And then we also offer a memorial scholarship in the name of Ryan M. Hansen, who was one of our volunteers, who sadly, very sadly, died before his 19th birthday. So Gary Gruby is one of our board members. This is his nephew. And we've hired one or two interns in Ryan Hansen's name, paid internships, I might add, so that these young individuals are getting some experience in helping us accomplish some of the work that needs to be done. So under the Special Fathers Network, which is sort of a signature program of the 21st Century Dads Foundation, there's information on mentor fathers, becoming a mentee father. There's a closed Facebook group. There's banner ads if you want to help promote the Special Fathers Network at your website or other websites. There's the podcast series, which I made reference to. We have mastermind groups, which you'll learn a little bit more about. And then I would say most importantly, one of our best opportunities to reach young families, early intervention age families, families with children 0 to 3, is the Early Intervention Parent Survey. So if you're a young dad who's participating or know of other young dads who have a child with special needs, I would strongly encourage you to take the Early Intervention Parent Survey. There are a number of different ways to get involved. In addition to donating, you can volunteer the survey again. We're always looking to recruit mentee fathers. You can host a cycle to end father absence event, which is an indoor riding event. The banner ads again, there's a 21 CD pledge. And then there's some additional resources. And as far as events are concerned, we have the Dad's Honor Ride coming up, which I made reference to. There's the virtual conference, which we're participating in. There's other upcoming events. And if you looked at past events, for some reason that's not doing what it's supposed to do. You could see the past conferences and other events. And then there's some suggested readings. Many of the individuals, the 250 plus individuals who are mentee fathers or those that have done podcast interviews are also authors. And we've tried to profile each of their books and then some. So it's a very rich resource as far as reading materials. And then under other resources, there are a number of different videos and podcasts, not just our own podcasts, to make yourself aware of. And anyway, I thought it was worth just taking a moment to allow people to understand that there's a lot of resources at the 21st Century Dads website. So what I'd like to do with no further ado is to introduce my longtime friend, fellow 21st Century Dads Foundation board member, SFN mentor father, grand dude, and author, serial entrepreneur, gifted performer, and podcast dad number 56 to share some remarks and kick us off with his rendition of the national anthem. Wayne Messmer, the Zoom screen is yours.
Thank you, David. Good morning, gentlemen. You know, I always love telling the story of the first time that I got involved with David and his mission that has grown so wonderfully. And getting one of the Father of the Year trophies and one of the most significant awards that I believe I've ever received as a stepdad, and now as a grandfather of four, or as I did alluded, I am the grand dude, as I love to be called. So I applaud all of you, not only for the work that you're doing, but the fact that you've stepped up to the line here to share with the guys. I like to point out I'm not as dumb as I look. I have a PhD in psychology, so this fascinates me when we have guys who take the deep breath and say, I need to talk to some other guys. And I know that that's at the heart of what drives David with his passion. And enough about that. But I'm proud to be here this morning, standing here in my, as I call them, happy pants, up at our lake house in Wisconsin, being very reflective and receptive as well to what's going to happen today. So without further ado, for those of you who don't know me, I've been a national anthem guy for over 40 years, sung well over 5,000 times professionally the national anthem, including World Series and NHL Stanley Cup Finals and Calder Cup Finals and all that fun stuff, all-star games. But someone says, what is the most important national anthem that you have ever sung? And I will always say, the next one I sing, which is this, simply because I have been touched by an angel, to say the least. Had a misfortune in 1994, a shooting that almost took my life and my voice, without going into detail, but shot point blank with a 9mm in the neck. To recover, to be able to still do this, is nothing short of a miracle, which I will now share with you as we honor America. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the Sorry if I blew out your speakers.
Well, that was wonderful, Wayne. Thank you. And a couple people leading up to the event today said, well, what about all these people from different countries? You know, do you think they're going to want to hear the national anthem, the U.S. national anthem? And maybe their special request, because you've sang the Canadian national anthem, haven't you?
Oh, yeah, many times. Mexican, Spanish, Polish, the Hatikva for Israel. What else? So, yeah, have national anthem, we'll travel.
Well, thank you for being with us. Thank you for being part of the network. Thank you for helping us kick off this event. And just thank you for your friendship.
You're doing a great work. Thank you.
Yeah, be well. Okay. Well, we seem to be right on schedule. The next session is to discuss the mastermind and meetup groups. So let me just briefly describe what we're doing and why we're doing what we're doing. And then I'll ask two of our Special Fathers Network mentor fathers to reflect on their experience. So we got into this at the very beginning thinking we're just going to recruit a group of seasoned fathers with 10 or more years of experience. And we're going to call them our mentor fathers. And we're going to match those dads with younger dads, dads that are close to the beginning of their journey, raising a child with a similar special need. And the good news is we've recruited well over 500 Special Fathers Network mentor fathers from all over the country and now outside the US. And we're always looking to add additional mentor fathers to the group. What the dads have told us is that's nice, but you know, that's not exactly what I'm looking for. So some of the dads are looking to meet on a monthly basis, in person or virtually. So we've created the concept of these Special Fathers Network dad meetup groups, which are monthly experiences, mostly virtually, but some of them are meeting in person as well. And we provide them with resources, the dads that are leading these groups. And that includes, usually if it's a monthly meeting, a 75-minute meeting that is broken up into, I'll let them describe, but there's a format that we've created, a template. And then we also have mastermind groups, which are meetings on a weekly basis. These are virtual. And then part of the mastermind experience is an annual retreat, which we'll talk a little bit more about. So these dads are taking a deeper dive, meeting on a weekly basis. And I might be quick to add that they on average pay $100 a month to participate. It's an investment that they're making into being a more intentional father. And I'm pleased to report we have 20 dads in two different groups meeting on Tuesday and Wednesday nights. So if you're curious to know more about those groups, you can find information at the website, or you can reach out to me or send an inquiry. But so you're not just hearing it from me, but you're hearing it from two of the dads that are involved. I'd like to ask Duncan Kia from Nairobi, Kenya, and Nathan Warner from Colorado to be our featured speakers and talk about their experience with the dad meetup groups and the mastermind group. So Duncan, I'm going to suggest that you go first, all the way from Nairobi, Kenya, Duncan Kia. And if you would, make a brief self-introduction so people understand who you are and what your connection is to the world of special needs.
Thank you, David. I hope all of you can hear me. I'm Duncan Kia from beautiful Nairobi, Kenya, the land of the Big Five. I met David, more than a year ago through an acquaintance who introduced me. So basically, I will introduce myself. I'm a father of four, but two of my kids have special needs. That is Luca, who's seven. He's living with autism. And Halai, who's three. She's autistic and also was born with albinism. So quite a challenge raising two kids with special needs, especially in this in sub-Saharan Africa, because autism and albinism is not widely understood. I'm grateful that I come from a part of the continent where there's a lot of information about autism, especially, and albinism. There's a lot of awareness in terms of trying to get people to understand what autism is. Challenges range from cultural stigmatization in terms of most people don't understand what autism is, or stigmatize people living with albinism. So it's been a challenge. Special needs are considered stigma in sub-Saharan Africa and basically most African countries. So when I got introduced to David, and he gave me his idea about having a forum of dads who could talk about raising kids with special needs, which was something very close to my heart, I took it on. African dads, I would say, I want to throw them under the bus because they don't like talking about raising kids with special needs. They have this face they put on and basically don't see, don't talk. Unfortunately, the statistics don't favor us in terms of most African dads actually walk out of marriages when their wives give birth to special needs kids. It is a sad situation, but with more information and with more, you know, encouragement, we are seeing a change in that. So I started a group in Nairobi. I reached out to parents, to dads who are raising kids with special needs. Since it was COVID time, it was all online. So I tried to reach out online. I The initial response was overwhelming. In fact, it was mostly wives reaching out on behalf of their husbands because they knew their husbands would not want to talk about this. So most wives were reaching out on behalf of their husbands. So we started a group. Initially, we had a group of over 30 people. And I arranged a first online meeting, and the response was good. We had, I think, a turnover of over 60% or 70%, which, trust me, is amazing in this part of the world, especially for African dads. So challenges. So basically the group, I still maintain the group, and we communicate majorly online through media like WhatsApp media or phone calls. Most of the dads in the group I have actually reach out personally. They don't like talking about the issues they have in the group, which I totally understand. It's small steps, but I'm willing to fight the fight. So we meet, we talk and discuss about issues or awareness or programs that the government is running in terms of helping children going through these challenges. It's been tough trying to get participation because getting an African dad to open up is like trying to milk or to get water out of a stone. But it is baby steps. David will tell you we have brainstormed on different strategies, and we keep trying to find the best way possible to get the dads to really participate. It is not a lost cause. I'm still talking and engaging them one-on-one or in the group. I intend in June to have a physical meetup with the dads. Nairobi is fortunate enough that we have a lot of awareness in terms of special needs. And there's a lady who has a cafe that is a coffee shop that basically has the waiters are people with special needs. And so I intend to host the meeting there or try to get to host the meeting there where I'll invite the dads for us just to talk, and I'll tell them not to think of anything serious and just come and talk to any of the dads. It's been an eye opener. I'm trying to shatter the stigma, trying to shatter cultural barriers. As I mentioned earlier, I can tell you I get phone calls from wives giving me their husbands' numbers to reach out to them. I try. But most of the time I tell them, look, you must first talk to him to ask him if he's willing or interested. That is when I can reach out, because it's awkward to have a conversation with someone who's not heard about me or who doesn't know about this group. So it's challenging, but it is also fun, busting myths. Acceptance is a hard thing. I'm sure the dads in this group have had to go through the phase of acceptance. I'm a fairly young parent, so it took me a while to accept that I'm raising kids with special needs, but I've taken it on with stride. I'm a big advocate for kids being raised with special needs in Kenya, Nairobi, Kenya. I'm happy to be here. Hope to connect with all of you and hope to build a wider network, especially in sub-Saharan Africa. And maybe one day I can meet most of you face-to-face and talk about the issues we go through.
Thank you so much for sharing. I really appreciate the work that you're doing there in Nairobi. I love getting the WhatsApp messages, you know, that I'm able to see. And if there's anything else that we can do to support your efforts, don't hesitate to reach out. And I'm hoping that you're from your lips to God's ears, that we will be able to meet face to face, whether it's here in the US or there in Nairobi. Okay, we have a very tight agenda. Oh, the only thing you overlooked was that you were featured as podcast guest number 201. as part of the Special Fathers Network Dad to Dad podcast. So if you want to learn a little bit more about Duncan and his family and the work that he's doing, it's episode number 201. Okay, Nathan Werner, you have just 4 minutes.
Sounds great.
Discuss everything you know about the Mastermind Group. And Nathan was episode podcast dad number 114.
114. Very brief introduction. Nathan Werner. We currently live in Denver, Colorado, just outside of Denver, Colorado. Got a five-year-old daughter with Angelman syndrome about 4 years ago. Actually at this conference, at the virtual conference 4 years ago, found out about it the day before, jumped on board and had a conversation with David during one of the breakout sessions. Been a special Fathers Network dad since then, helped plan the last two virtual conferences as well. Because of that, I understand a lot of what's going on in David's head and how we want to, what we want to do with this great organization. He invited me at the first year to join up with the Mastermind Group, which wasn't going to work for my schedule because I lived in Tokyo at the time. But we have moved now back to the States, and so I joined up with the Mastermind Group number two, which meets on Tuesday evening. And it's been a really, really fantastic experience. We've been able to develop friendships with folks that I had not met before, but man, there's a kindred spirit, not necessarily exactly the same experience, but a shared enough experience that it really does knit us together. I really appreciate the way that we have organized and structured this, where it isn't just a get together and small talk. There's some really deep, some really challenging, some really painful conversations that happen. And at the same time, it's not just a complaint session. It's not just my life is miserable, woe is me. It's always an encouraging time. So as one of my friends here said, we don't wear the same shoes, but we shop at the same shoe store. We experience a similar enough life that we can benefit from each other's experiences. For years, I have thought that that I would walk through fire to help the next dad behind me, the next person behind me that might have to go through this. And to have some people like these guys that are in this Mastermind Group that have already walked through it in front of me and kind of said, watch out for this. And here's something to think about. And here's how to really love your family and wife well. It's been really, really good. So I needed a place here in Denver when I first moved here. I didn't know anybody. About four months into our life here, we realized we really didn't have any close friends. So I decided I needed it. And so I pursued a monthly dad meetup group here. Started out with two dads, and it's grown to about a network of about 20 dads. And it's all word of mouth. It's all folks that I met along the way. And we have a great community. We have a great opportunity to share one another's burdens, to encourage each other and to connect with each other. So I am excited to be a part of that group as well as the Mastermind Group. I would highly recommend talking with Dave about joining the Mastermind Group that does start up again another year this summer. And Dave would be happy to connect you with them. And at the same time, if you need anything in regards to creating a special dads meetup group within your network, within your community, feel free to reach out to David and we can work on helping you out, equipping you in that too. He has been a great help for me in being a good dad.
Nathan, thank you. Just for the record, that was not a paid testimonial, but I really appreciate those kind words. And whenever I see that background that you have, I always think that that's like a man lost in the woods, right? But you're not lost in the woods, Nathan. And just thrilled to have you as part of the Special Fathers Network and specifically the Mastermind Group and the effort that you're making to help us with the meetup groups and expand the meetup group concept. And he's one of the younger dads, which is pretty remarkable. Your daughter Ada is what, 4 years old, 5 years old? Yeah, just amazing. So. I just love your intentionality. It's a great role model for us older dads as well.